Welcome, viewers, to we're here at the Cavelli Kitchen. I'm joined by Chef Isaac
Lewa.
And I'll let him just introduce himself, tell us a little bit about himself and some experience. Chef?
I'm Chef Isaac Lewa from Kenya. I've joined the hotel industry for about 21 years now.
Wow.
Having worked in the kitchen, and I have been a chef for 14 years now.
Wow. Very nice. Impressive. There we have it. So we know we're dealing with a senior over here, and I can see some nice things on the table. Chef, what are you going to be teaching us to make today?
Today, first and foremost, Cavelli is a continental kitchen.
Okay.
Yeah, but
continental meaning you make foods from
different backgrounds of people, different types of cuisine.
Parts of the world. Okay.
Yeah, we are. But at first it was Italian oriented, but according to the market that we have in Kampala, we changed it to continental. So today here we have varieties of items of which we wanted us to prepare.
Okay.
But here we have some of the spices that we use in Cavelli Kitchen. To name but a few, we have the oregano.
Okay.
We have white pepper, black pepper powder. We have chicken masala. We have aromat. We have chili powder. We have turmeric. And then some of the sauces like oyster sauce, soy sauce, and also have the chili sauce.
Okay.
Don't forget to
cream.
Complete the taste or the flavor of the meal, of food. It is good for us to add the cream.
Cream.
Yeah, this is complementing the taste.
Okay.
Of the food. Now today I want us to jump to one of our favorite food items here at Cavelli.
Okay.
Called the oyster beef.
Oyster beef.
Oyster beef is Chinese oriented. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's Chinese oriented.
Okay.
And the method of cooking that we are using to prepare the oyster beef is just the stir fry.
Stir frying. A lot of heat, very few minutes.
Yeah, very few minutes.
Okay.
But over a lot of heat while the frying pan is ready hot.
Very hot.
On the fire.
Okay.
Then we just do it within a minute.
Okay.
Or within the shortest time possible.
All right.
And we just serve it and go. But it has the best flavor and taste.
Fantastic. Yeah. Fantastic. Okay, so we're making oyster beef, yes?
Yeah, here we're making oyster beef.
The ingredients
oyster
are...
Oyster beef is Chinese-oriented.
Yes.
Yeah, Chinese-oriented.
Mm-hmm.
Where we use the method of cooking as
the stir-fried. Okay.
Which you put the pan on a high flame.
Yes.
And then you stir-fry it shortly. Yeah.
Yeah.
With the ingredients. And also some vegetables. The only thing in this one, the only secret in this one is the cutting. You have to make sure that the cutting of the meat and the cutting of the vegetables, they rhyme. They all look the same shape. They all look of the same size as well.
So which technique is this we've used?
So, and also you have to bear in mind, because it is a business, you have to bear in mind the grammage.
Okay.
The grammage also, or rather portioning of the meat.
Okay. So viewers, this is professional stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The portioning always. Portioning of meat. All professionals know that portioning of meat.
Yes.
If it is a flesh.
Yes.
Without bone. It is between 180 grams to 200 grams.
Per serving.
That is per portion, one person.
Okay.
So you should make sure that the portioning of the meat doesn't exceed 200 grams.
Okay.
And then also the cutting of the vegetables or the cutting of the meat, which is diced.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Should be of the same size also.
So diced
meat,
beef, diced vegetables.
Vegetables. okay. of the same size.
Okay.
And then we have the very favorable sauces for the stir-fried mm-hmm. oyster beef.
Okay.
Which is the oyster sauce.
All right.
And also the soya sauce.
Okay. Dark, light, or this is, doesn't matter?
No. We prefer the light soya. Okay. Rather than the dark, because when you use the dark soya, okay. it looks very dark in color, and
okay.
it doesn't give the right color even for the one who is eating it, to the consumer.
Okay.
So these are the very most recommended sauces for the
oyster beef. Okay.
Don't forget the garlic.
All right.
Yeah.
Okay.
Garlic must be there.
Okay.
Onions must be there, but we have already included the onions in the vegetables.
Yes.
So now we are heading to where our frying pan is.
Okay.
To do the cooking of oyster beef now.
Okay. Great. Thank you. Let me this.
Make sure the pan is red hot. When the pan is wet, put it on a high flame,
okay.
and make sure that the water is completely dry,
okay.
before you start your cooking.
Okay.
Yeah. Now we are waiting for the frying pan to be dry. And here we have our vegetables. I proposed that we serve the oyster beef with mashed potato because goes so well with mashed potato,
okay.
and a touch of mushroom sauce, yeah, which is the, I can say it is the most favorable,
okay.
yeah, it, which that goes so well with the mashed potatoes.
Sounds interesting,
yeah.
Very interesting.
Now here we are. We start cooking our oyster beef now.
Okay. So we'll just use normal vegetable oil, yeah?
Yeah, this is the normal vegetable oil.
Okay.
Yeah. Put your oil. But
just a tiny bit of oil.
I prefer, yes, because nowadays people are moving away from the fatty foods.
Yes.
There you need to be very careful with the quantity of oil that you use.
Okay.
Yeah. Now, for a good flavor of the meal,
yes.
I prefer adding the oil with a little bit of olive oil. Yeah. For the flavor and also the aroma of the food.
Good.
Just put a little bit of olive oil. Yeah. Then we will use garlic, but because garlic is too tiny, we first fry the vegetables.
Okay.
According to their sizes.
Okay.
Now here are the mixed vegetables. We start with the onion, as usual.
So the flame, scary.
No. The flame is scary. It's scaring to one who has never been in the kitchen for a while, but for us, we know.
So the word for that, viewers, is flambe.
The flambe, yeah.
That's to flambe.
The flambe.
Yeah, it's very quick.
Very quick,
very
too fast.
Hot.
You don't take a lot of time in preparing the oyster beef.
I think this is what sets apart Chinese cuisine
of course, any other cuisine. Most of the Chinese cuisines take short time to prepare, because the most time that they take longer is when doing the garnishes for the Chinese cuisine. Now then we can add the garlic.
Okay.
I'm trying as much as possible to avoid fats.
Okay.
Yeah. Mm. Fat foods, because you know, the food nowadays that we eat.
So also this stir frying method is good for maintaining the color of the vegetables.
Of course.
Maintaining because the crunchiness, freshness.
Yeah. There you are. Now,
yes.
For the meat. Mm-hmm. For the meat. Me, I prefer blanching the meat, grilling. Yeah, okay. Grilling the meat a little for a while, and then I mix it in.
Okay.
In with our vegetables.
All right.
So I put the meat.
You go to our already preheated grill.
Yes, preheated grill.
Okay.
Already preheated, and then you put the seasoned meat.
Seasoned salt and
with
pepper.
Salt, with salt and the soya, the light soya.
So the cut of meat we've used today is beef fillet.
The beef fillet, yeah.
Beef fillet.
Cubes.
This is a very prime cut of meat. This is very soft, tender.
Yeah, because most of the times I prefer giving my customers the best.
Yes.
So there are different types of cuts for beef.
Yeah.
We have, and they differ according to their toughness or something like that.
Yeah.
If you have the false fillet, if you have the top side, if you have the ram steak, and you have, if you have the sirloin, if you have the fillet, of course you know what type of method you do to that.
Yeah.
But as for the fillet, because the most tender part of beef, that's what I am always going for. I just most of the times want to
keep my
clients to eat the best. Yeah,
this is excellent.
Now, one thing with the grilling that you should know is. If you put the meat on the grill, just keep it time to brown it down.
Okay.
Yeah, don't turn it immediately. Okay. Give it time to brown down, and then you turn it so that you can seal. Can seal the fats and the nutrients that are inside. Okay. But if you turn it quickly, you will see that it is producing the gravy. We call it the gravy, which is the nutrients now it is going out.
Okay.
But as for now. You are seeing there is nothing like water coming out because we have given it time.
Yeah.
We are properly sealing it. Yeah. And then we turn it.
Flip it over.
Yeah.
So high heat.
High heat.
Very fast cooking.
Very fast. You are even sealing the nutrients in.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I like this. This is amazing. Wow. So
now from here
we
switch on the light again.
Okay.
Make sure that our pan is red hot.
Okay.
Then we take our meat. Now it depends. Sometimes clients say they want rare, they want well done, they want medium. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So it depends on the preference of the client.
You have no personal preference, or?
For me, I prefer the medium rare.
Medium rare.
Yeah.
Okay.
Because the meat is still very, very soft and tender.
Yeah.
That's what I prefer mostly.
Okay.
Here we are. Now. We are making our oyster beef.
So, flipping that part.
Tossing. Yeah, we are tossing.
How long did it take you to get that good?
It depends. It depends. Sometimes you can say it. Sometimes talent also matters
talent,
a lot. Yeah. If maybe you are talent and interest. If you are too much interested in cooking, it doesn't take you a lot of time.
Yeah.
You can just arrive there.